Connoisseurs of disease and putrefaction, the Rotmire Creed delight in spreading plague amongst the unwary and the unwanted. Hello, and welcome to this tutorial. In this tutorial, we're going to show you how to take certain aspects from your Warcry Heart of Gur, Rotmire Creed Warband, from battle ready to parade ready. We'll be focusing on the Witherlord that we painted in the previous video, so if you haven't seen that, go and check it out. All the colours that we are going to use on the Witherlord can be applied to the rest of your Rotmire Creed Warband. So, the first thing that we're going to do is focus on the greens, and for this we're going to need Sons of Horus green, Strachan green, and Nurgling green. So, let's get some Sons of Horus green onto the palette. So I'm just going to get just a couple of dollops of Sons of Horus green. Let's put it on. Let's get some water just to thin it out. And then start getting my brush to a nice sharp point. So just by twisting it like that, I just manipulate the bristles, and there we go. So what we're looking to do is just to pick out some of the edges of the trousers, and just using the side of the brush there, and just gliding it along all the edges. Just take your time when doing this, and if you make any mistakes, you can just tidy up with Lupercal Green. With that highlight completed on the trousers, we're now going to focus on highlighting the robe. So what we need to do is use Strachan Green and then just use the edge of the brush and start picking out the edges of the robe. And with that stage complete, we're now going to use Nurgling Green just to pick out the most raised areas of the robe. So you're looking for sharp edges just like this over here. Just picking that out there. And then just going around all the robe trying to find those areas. Another good thing to do when doing this is you can just use the very tip of your brush and just add some small scratches to the robe, just like that. This will help to give it a little bit of texture and make it look nice and worn. And with that second highlight applied and the little scratches put in, you can see how we've helped to bring the robe to life a bit. The next thing that we need to do is to focus on doing the browns, and for this we're going to be using Gorthal Brown, Baneblade Brown, Scrag Brown, Deathclaw Brown, as well as Wraithbone for the bamboo bits. So, the first thing that we need to do is get some Gorthal Brown onto the palette. Get my brush. Just apply that to the palette. A little bit of water after just cleaning the brush there. Put that in. Yeah. So, there's a little bit too much water there, so I'm just going to get a bit more of the paint. Put that there. Clean the brush a bit. So don't be afraid just to start again when you need to with it, because you don't want it to be too watery. Yeah, that's good just there. So get my brush at a nice sharp point. And then what we're going to look to do is to pick out all the bark bits that we have on the wood. So don't worry about being too neat when doing this. All you want to do is just gently run your brush along the raised areas of the bark. So you can see what I'm doing there. And what that does is just naturally pick out the little raised details that you can see in it. And just take your time when doing this and go over all the areas where you've painted dryad bark from the previous video. With that stage complete, the next thing that we are going to do is to use Baneblade Brown. And use this just to pick out the very edges of the wood. With that second highlight applied, the dark wood is now complete. The next thing that we're going to focus on is picking out all the brown leather. For this, we're using Scrag Brown. And just going around and picking out all the edges on the leather work. Just take your time when doing this. And remember just to use the very tip of your brush or the very side of your brush just to gently glide over the raised edges of the leather. It's going to be all the leather work around his feet, the rope that he's holding on to, as well as the leather rope and strings that are carrying the medicine jars. With that stage complete, we are now going to use Deathclaw Brown just to pick up the most raised areas of all the brown leather. So when doing the leather around the legs, you can just see here, I'm picking out the raised edges of it. This will help to show that the light is coming from up top, and it's going to be the same thing when painting the rope that he's holding on his weapon. So I'm just picking out the raised edges of the rope. And with that stage complete, our leather and rope details are now finished. The next thing that we're going to do is to use Wraithbone just to highlight all our bamboo. So we're just using this very sparingly and just going over the very tips of all the bamboo. And with that stage complete, all the brown details on the model are fully highlighted, as you can see there. The next thing that we need to do is to focus on doing the black and the gray details. And for this, we're going to be using Dawnstone to highlight the dark gray as well as the black, and then Ulthuan gray and white scar to highlight the light gray. So the first thing that we need to do is get some Dawnstone onto the palette. So I'm just going to take a dollop of Dawnstone here, just put it onto my palette, like that. Just get some water just to thin it out. Happy with that there. Let's get the brush to a nice sharp point. Then what we're going to do is just look to highlight where the Mechanicus Standard Grey is. So just over here on his wristband. So just picking out the edges. With the dark grey details now fully highlighted, as you can see here, I also highlighted the grey rope. The next thing that we need to do is to highlight the light grey details. So I'm going to be picking out the light grey here on the weapon, as well as the light grey jars and the skull glyph on his back. With the Ulthuan grey now applied, we're going to focus the white scar just onto the skull glyph on his back. So what we're going to do is just gently drag the edge of our brush over all the edges of the skull, looking to paint within the lines of where we used the Ulthuan grey previously. Just take your time when doing this, and if you make any mistakes, just tidy back up with Ulthuan grey. And with that stage complete, all the light grey details are now fully highlighted. The next thing that we need to do is to move on to doing the skin and the bone highlights. And for this, we're going to be using Bugman's Glow, Cadian Fleshstone, Morcus Bone, Screaming Skull, and finally, Pallid Witch Flesh. So, the first thing that we need to do is get some Bugman's Glow onto the palette. I'm just going to get a dollop of Bugman's Glow here, and get it onto my palette, like that. And get some water just to thin it out. I'm just going to need a little bit more, still a bit goopy, just a little bit more. There we go, happy with that. Now I'm just going to get my brush to a nice sharp point just by rolling it. And what we're looking to do here is just to re-layer over where we've painted the toad, making sure to keep the Bugman's Glow over the raised details and not get it into any of the recesses. With the Bugman's Glow now reapplied, the next thing that we need to do is to use Cadian Fleshstone just to pick out some of the features. And with that stage complete, the toad is now fully highlighted. The next thing that we need to do is re-layer over all the skulls using Morcus Bone, making sure to keep the shading in the recesses. With the layer of Morgas Bone applied, we're now going to highlight using Screaming Skull. You're just looking to pick out all the raised edges of all the bone details. With that stage complete, the skull details are now finished. The next thing that we need to do is to use pallid witch flesh and just pick out all the raised areas of the skin. And with that stage complete, the skin is now fully highlighted. We're now going to move on to doing the metallic details, and for this we're going to be using Runefang steel and Hashut copper. So we need to get some Runefang steel onto the palette. Just going to get a dollop of Runefang steel here, put it onto the palette, a little bit of water just to thin it out, and get my brush to a nice sharp point. So what we're looking to do here is just use the Runefang steel just to highlight all the silver metallics. Just take your time when doing this, and as you can see, I'm using the edge of my brush just to drag along the raised edges. With the silver metallic now highlighted, we need to use Hashut copper to highlight the bronze metallics. And with that stage complete, the metallics are now fully highlighted. What we need to do next is focus on doing the base, and for this we're going to use Morghast bone to dry brush a highlight over it, and then we're going to use Mordian corpse grass tufts in order to give the base some extra detail. So the first thing that we need to do is get some Morghast bone onto our paintbrush. So I'm just going to get some Morghast bone straight from the pot here, and then try and get as much of the paint off as I can on this bit of paper here, because we want the paint to be nice and dry on the bristles. So while you're doing this, you can see how I'm working the pigment into the brush. Just testing it there. Yeah, are you happy with that? And then what we're going to do is just lightly brush over the top of all the texture paint to give it a nice natural highlight. And there you go, the base is now nicely highlighted. What we need to do next is add some Mordian corpse grass tufts to it. So what we're going to do is just get our Mordian corpse grass here, and then I'm just going to apply that to the base where I want it. So I'm just going to put it down there, push it there, and then I'm going to use my texture tool just to push the Mordian corpse grass tuft onto the base, because it comes with a little bit of adhesive underneath it, so you don't need any glue or anything like that. Just a little bit of downward pressure, and that helps to apply it quite nicely. So I'm just going to add a couple of more, and then we'll see you afterwards. So with those grass tufts applied, our Rotmire Creed Witherlord is now fully parade ready. With the base completed, our parade-ready Witherlord is ready to spread the gifts of plague and pox to all he encounters. So there are just a couple of things to remember. When edge highlighting, try and use the edge or the side of your brush as much as you can, because this will make edge highlighting a lot easier and your lines a lot smoother. Also, when applying tufts, just remember that they have some adhesive underneath them, so you don't need to use glue if you don't want to. Well, we hope you've enjoyed this video, and we hope you enjoy painting your own Warcry Heart of Gur Rotmire Creed to a parade-ready standard, and we look forward to seeing you again soon. Goodbye!